In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying uniformly varying load. The arrangement for the beam is as shown over here. The span length of the beam is L and it carries a uniformly varying load of W kilonewton per meter. So at x is equal to 0, the load is 0, and at x is equal to L, the value of load is W kilonewton per meter. Now first we'll find out the general expression for shear force at any section xx at a distance x from the free end A. So from the similarity of the triangle, so we'll consider two triangles. So this is the smaller triangle that we are considering and this will be the larger triangle that we are considering. So height, that is y, divided by base, that is x, of smaller triangle has to be equal to height, that is w, divided by base, that is capital L, for the larger triangle. So therefore we can say that y will be equal to, now cross multiply by this x to this, so it is w upon L into x. So we can say that shear force at any section xx will be equal to, it is minus 1/2 base into height. So base is x and height just now we have calculated, that is y, is w upon L into x. And the shear force acting in the downward direction, so it is considered as negative. So it is minus 1/2 into x, and value of y is w upon L into x. So it is minus w upon 2L x square in kilonewton. So shear force diagram conventions, upward force is positive and downward force is negative. So we have written the general expression for shear force at any section xx. Just now we have calculated that particular value. At point A, value of x is 0 because this is the starting point of x. So we are measuring x from A towards B. So x is equal to 0. So therefore shear force at A is equal to 0 because x is 0. Shear force at B, so x is equal to L over here. So in place of x, substitute L, L square and L, 1L will get cancelled up. So it is minus 1/2 W L. Now we'll draw the shear force diagram. So at A it is 0 and at B it is minus 1/2 W into L, and it is a second degree equation, so it is a parabolic curve. Similarly, we'll find out the general expression for bending moment at any section xx. So first we'll allow that particular shear force that we have calculated. So shear force at any section xx is W upon 2L x square acting in the downward direction. So allow it to act. So we'll convert this UVL into a point load acting at the centroid of this particular triangular lamina. So for the triangular section, the centroid will act at a distance of base upon 3. So base for the smaller triangle is x, so it is 1/3 into x. Now we have to take the moment about section xx. So it will be force multiplied by perpendicular distance. So you can see it will produce, this particular will produce the anti-clockwise moment. So force is W upon 2L into x square, and as it is anti-clockwise, it is negative, and the perpendicular distance is 1/3 into x. So it is minus W upon 6L, 2 into 3, that is 6, x square into x, that is x cube, kilonewton meter. So we can say that in case of bending moment diagram, the conventions that we are using is clockwise positive, anti-clockwise negative. So bending moment at any section xx, just now we have calculated, it is minus W upon 6L x cube. At A, x is equal to 0, so bending moment will be 0. At B, x is equal to L, so in place of x, substitute L cube. So L cube and L will get cancelled out. So it is minus W by 6 L square kilonewton meter. So it is a cubic equation, third degree equation that we are obtaining. So in this way, we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying uniformly varying load. Thank you very much for watching.